This Blender tutorial is a simple one, and it's all about HDRIs, also known as HDR images or high dynamic range images. These can be used as 360 degree backgrounds for your Blender scene, or to add realistic lighting very easily. They're simple to add, you can get a lot of them for free, and they're awesome, so let's check them out. So where do you get HDRIs to use in Blender? Well, lots of places, but a great one with lots of free HDRIs is Polyhaven, formerly known as HDRI Haven. Click Browse HDRIs and you'll be able to look through tons of them. Some have skies with different lighting conditions and some have interior scenes. You'll see some of studio lights. These are called studio HDRIs. You can use HDRIs for a background image, but you can also use them just for lighting, even if you don't want the background image to be seen. Each image will show you some previews of what this HDRI looks like on a sphere. You can filter by category over here. Click on one and you have a few more preview options. For example, here's a render where the HDRI isn't even visible, but it's being used to light the entire scene. The 3D option puts you right in the middle of the HDRI, and you can scroll to look around. So let's say we want this HDRI. We have download options up here. Another thing to notice is the license. This one has a CC0 license. The CC is for Creative Commons, and the 0 is for zero attribution required. This means you can use this HDRI for anything, and you don't have to give credit to the original author. That's nice. But if you ever see something different when you're downloading assets in general, do some research on what you're allowed to do with whatever it is you're downloading. So back to download options. You have different resolutions, and they generally go up pretty high. If you're going to use the image as an actual background that you'll see in your render, you probably want to go pretty high on the resolution. Probably like 16K. If it's just for lighting, you can get away with a little bit lower resolution. You've also got different file types. Here we have EXR and HDR. HDR will be a smaller file, but not as wide of a color range. The whole high dynamic part of HDRIs means they have a very wide range of color. So they're not normally in JPEG or PNG form, but sometimes they are. Blender supports EXR, and that's what I would recommend unless saving space and memory is a really big concern. So download and save it somewhere on your computer. The image you download will be a bit distorted if you open it because these are designed to wrap around your scene in a spherical shape. Imagine wrapping a map around the globe. So let's go into Blender, but don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you've made it this far. Thanks. Here's a little city project I've been working on for a while. I use it in some of my work, which you can, of course, check out on Instagram. To add the HDRI to this scene, we are going to go into the shading workspace. In the shading editor, we change this drop-down box from object to world. If you don't see a node setup, you may have to make sure that use nodes is checked on. Our default for this world setting is a background node plugged into the surface of a world output node. Press Shift A and search for an environment texture node, or you can find it under the texture category. Press open on the environment texture and navigate to where your HDRI file is. Then plug the color output of the environment texture into the color input of the background node. That's it. The HDRI won't show up in material preview mode or in solid mode. It'll only show up in render preview mode, and of course in your final render. There's your HDRI in the scene. You can see it's emitting light, which is affecting the entire scene. We can increase or decrease the strength of the HDRI's light output with the strength slider on the background node. So let's say we like this HDRI, but we want to reposition it. We would need to add a mapping setup to this environment texture. To do that, add a mapping node. Plug this vector output from the mapping node into the vector input of the environment node. Then we need to add a texture coordinate node. Plug the generated output of the texture coordinate node into the vector input of the mapping node. By the way, if you have the Node Wrangler add-on activated in your preferences, you can simply click the environment texture node and press Ctrl+T. This will automatically add this mapping setup for you, and it saves a lot of time. So now with this mapping node, we can adjust the positioning of the HDRI background. We can rotate it along any axis we want. We can move its location, like moving it up and down, for instance. Or we can adjust its scale. For the most part, we probably just want to rotate it and maybe in some cases move it down slightly. If you render out your image or your animation, the HDRI will display in the background by default. But in some cases, you just want the HDRI's light to affect your scene, and you don't want the HDRI image actually rendered. There are two ways to do this. The simplest one is probably to go into your render property settings and find the film setting. Expand this and click the transparent option. This will render transparency where the world, or the HDRI, would be seen in your render. This is pretty useful for laying your render over another image for a background or for other compositing tricks. The second option is you can go into your World Properties tab, and under Ray Visibility, we can control how the light rays from the HDRI affect our render. Turning off camera means the HDRI background won't be visible directly to the camera, but all of the light it puts off in your scene will be. With the other settings, you can limit the light's impact on your scene. I really try to make these tutorials straight to the point, and I'd love to have you as a subscriber. See the description for some links to my favorite add-ons for Blender. Thank you.